to Music Emerging's Inspiring Talks. It is our first podcast. I'm Cynthia Brando. I'm creator of Music Emerging, and I'm your host. And then our co-host, we've got Pierson Keating. He is a musician and an author and a coach. And we have our first guest right here, Robert Alexander. And we're going to talk about all sorts of things. Before I introduce Robert, just want to say that Music Emerging is an emotional resource-based site for people in the music industry. So I want to create inspiring talks and interview people that have an inspiring story, that have gone through struggles in the music industry, and also people that might have a product that might be emotionally beneficial to our listeners. So you never know what the conversation, how the conversation's gonna go, but this is our launch. We're really excited to be here.
I'm totally excited.
Yeah.
And Robert, more over here. Thank you so much for having me, you guys. What a blessing.
Thanks Robert
for being
came
here.
All the way from Ventura, so we're
it's
happy.
Not that far away, really.
Yeah, it's not that
I
far
can teleport away. If you want to, so who knows.
And we are in, is this Los Feliz or Silver Lake?
This is Atwater Village.
Atwater.
We're in Los Angeles and Atwater
They're
Village.
They're our brothers and sisters anyway, so.
And we have this amazing art in this little nook, and it's the art of Robert Safian, who's graciously letting us use the space. So thank you, Robert.
The other Robert, yeah.
Oh, not this Robert. The other Robert.
Well, because I'm Robert Alexander. Remember,
Robert so. Soffer.
Robert Alexander, and there's another Robert in the other room, and that's where his house. This is his house.
Very awesome one, too, actually.
Yeah. It's a cool space. Anyway, so Robert Alexander, he is a musician. He has his own... Is it a music company or your label, or is it a label or just like kind of your alias? Evlov, right?
Oh, Evlov is my music project solely.
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
That's just me being a musician. I can go...
You produce, you engineer, do all that.
Exactly. Guitar, singing, that's a whole other conversation.
And it's the type of music is kind of ambient, right?
Yeah, well, again, I definitely love diversity. So basically what I do is... I play the guitar a little bit. You haven't heard too much of those on my recordings anyway, but I definitely have music for licensing and music on Spotify and Pandora, just like a lot of other artists. So
yeah,
well,
we're actually
going to
play. We're going to maybe, you know, when we get this podcast officially launched, we're going to have like a little piece we'll insert in there and we could hear what you do with your music. But
you.
Robert also, he's also a podcast person, and he has a podcast called Life Rhythms Radio. So, and it helps you organically explore, expand, and celebrate what is most important to you in the current chapter of your life. And I'm quoting Robert on that one. So, briefly, what is Life Rhythms Radio?
Sure. Well, Life Rhythms Radio, the little tagline is your life, your rhythm, your radio show. So, ultimately, wherever you are in this moment of your life, ultimately, you have something that resonates with you in terms of information, in terms of the guests, in terms of the topic, which is the information. So at the same time, too, it's modeled after my business, which is Life Rhythms.
Mm. Nice.
So you have a project, which is Evlov, that's your musical project, and
exactly.
Your business is Life Rhythms.
Absolutely.
So you're a pretty busy guy.
Yeah, the four-letter word, that's the one I tend to... It's pretty full.
Yeah, because
that's
the second thing. Then there's a third thing. He does... he calls himself an audio alchemist, which we're going to go into more detail, because I'm really interested in that. I know Pearson's interested in that topic, too. And he does something called resonance sessions and affirmations, where he fuses music with personal affirmations and also original music that are personalized for his clients that are for healing. So just briefly, what's the affirmations and the resonance series about?
Okay, so affirmation sessions, I really didn't like calling myself a coach. So that's just my thing. I mean, because there's so many things and it's very easy to, you know, put people in a box.
Right.
You know, I'd rather, you know, I wouldn't want people running for the hills. I want them to have, ideally, the intention is to have more of an intrigue. And so audio alchemist, I might bring them way over the hill, or at the same time to at least be able to bring some sort of intrigue, especially with magic and music. So for me, basically, when I do resonance sessions, it's just another way of me providing support. But I figured instead of it just being a coaching session, which I really wouldn't even call it coaching. It's a fusion of different things. I have these customized affirmations and even these other types of soundscapes, depending on what a person needs when I connect with them. So with that being said, I'll be able to provide those resonance sessions with that support. I mean, as support for the affirmations.
Right.
So you have the resonance as the groundwork, and then the affirmations can be practiced on top of that.
Yeah, well, what happens is, without getting... Of course, you have all the information So
yes,
well, at least,
yeah, well, we're going to connect you guys to all the information that goes into this in detail too.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. My intention is at least to give a little bit of information mm-hmm. without getting too overboard, and it's easy to go up. So my biggest intention is just to give as much as I can within, you know, good.
And so you compose these tracks?
Yeah, yeah. So what happens is, originally what happened was, doing these affirmations, I figured, great, I'll be able to connect with somebody. I have an hour session. And I'll be able to, for the first half, just have a simple dialogue and just really see what's happening, almost like an intake. Mm. And just having free rein, just have them talk. They can be as open, be as minimal as they want. Ultimately, the more better, the more words, the better off it is for them to actually just state. So I have a better understanding of what's going on. Usually I'm picking up some sort of challenge or circumstance. Sometimes things are great and they want to expand more on what's going on. So usually we're all up here, gosh, I don't know what to think, I don't know what's going on, and the session's recorded. So we can do this on video, we can do this on the phone, we can do this in person, and so at the end of the day, I've worked with people all over the world with this process. So at the end of the day, this is a recorded session. So the big part is bringing them to a state of feeling relaxed, and based mm-hmm. on the issues that are coming up, or the circumstances that are coming up, there might be some sort of sabotaging behavior or
sure.
some sort of thing that's happening
yeah.
behind it, right? And
yeah.
so sometimes people, they may not know. Sometimes people may know immediately and they can just sit
sure.
there a moment. Sometimes they would start crying. And that's natural. I mean, we're going over very personal stuff. This is all extremely confidential. So
yeah, I mean, I know it's confidential, but I was wondering in general, because since music emerging is for people in the industry,
yeah.
I was curious about artists, musicians, and other people that are entrepreneurs. What kind of like roadblocks are you noticing with them that they come to you for, like roadblocks, or what kind of traumas or challenges do they have in their life?
Well, I was going to say before I even go into that, which I'm more than happy to explain, because it's pretty common that even those that aren't musicians have a similar essence in that way,
yeah.
too. But specifically knowing this is a show for musicians, it's a big deal. So, yeah. With that being said, too, once we're at that place where they're feeling more expanded, I have my little tricks and a non-manipulative way to ask different questions and help them work with different aspects of themselves. Everyone has belief systems. There's a reason why I say life rhythm is your life, your rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
So I really want to make sure whatever languaging I'm using, whatever I'm offering up, they're feeling comfortable enough to actually connect with themselves. So the beautiful thing is, depending on how long I work with them, whether if it's a month from now, or even 2 weeks from now, or whatever period of time that I have with them, my intention is to ask them, okay, so here we are 2 weeks later than our original session, and here you are in this new state of mind, feeling more resolved and feeling more expanded.
Mm.
What's taking place?
Mm.
Yeah,
that's
your time travel aspect.
That's a time travel aspect.
Yeah, because I know there's four parts, right? There's like self-discovery, which you talked about, inner themes.
Yeah.
That could be that spiritual. You talk about co-creation and time traveling.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's three. Is there a fourth?
That was it. Self-discovery, inner themes, co-creation, and time travel.
Oh, that was, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, inner themes. What was
inner themes?
What was inner themes?
Well, there might be like inner themes. Like, let's say
yeah, stuff that comes up.
So, perfect example. Being a musician, I don't want to expose any personal stuff on the air here.
No, it's all open here.
So here's like Jimmy John. Just here we are, and he's coming to me, and gosh, I can't concentrate. I'm feeling lots of creative blocks, and gosh, here I am. I'm looking to get a manager, or here I am in this creative process, and there might be so much pressure happening with all these things, and there's so many paths, I don't know where to go. At the same time, too, there's all these different things that are going on. How do I pay my bills? How do
yeah,
I do this?
Stress.
How do I do this?
The usual rigmarole that comes up so often for musicians and a lot of other creative types.
And these people, they may not feel comfortable going to a therapist. Not to knock therapists, therapists do amazing work. Same thing with hypnotherapists. And I figured at the same time, too, like they say, for artists, or from artists for artists. Being able to create something that's, and with the work that I've done on myself, so just being able to go with the skills, and I'm continuing to evolve with my own journey as well, especially being a musician, being a sign label artist, seeing how people may feel uncomfortable even opening up their significant others, because maybe they're going through some major changes, they don't know who to talk to. This is a safe haven for them to explore this.
Great.
Not to say I'm curing them from everything. And that's what I'm saying. You may not be feeling as resolved after the first affirmation session.
Sure.
So what I normally do afterwards is, well, first of all,
there's no cure-all in life, in a way.
No,
it's like you
no.
have to put the work into it.
If they're willing and open to it.
The personal work.
And usually the first one might even open some stuff up. They're like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize this is going on. And it's opening up your subconscious. It's opening up a lot that's happening in that.
Mm-hmm.
So my intention is the next day, especially, is to offer that support. There's a whole other process with the affirmation too, right? How to envision an image. And what I do too afterwards is actually create a customized piece of ambient music from scratch for, in this case, it would be, you know, for you.
Okay.
So nobody on this planet has it. I take that recording, that last bit of it, and that way you have a high quality MP3 file.
Mm. And I can just listen to that any time of the day.
The intention is to listen to it usually during the morning or at night, or even
right.
if you're stressed or triggered, boom, listen to it. But at the end of the day too, go ahead.
I could listen to it in the gym if I wanted.
Absolutely.
Just
you
like
have your headphones.
Driving around LA, just put it on the radio, put it on the...
You can blast it if you want to. At the end of the day, you're hearing yourself in a positive essence and the way you want to be.
Mm-hmm.
Your embodied sense in terms of, oh yeah, this is what's going on. I don't feel stressed. I feel more clear in my head.
Okay,
I mean, you're really
okay.
affirming these things. Because in terms of having a full-blown affirmation, recording affirmations, just a general one, I mean, in essence, my intention is are to do some of those. The way they've been out there, I figure it's a great catch-all. You may listen to one part of it and go, whoa, 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 I don't know if I really resonate with that.
Mm-hmm.
So this is literally for you. Nobody on this planet has it.
And that's what really interested me, like, you know, the audio alchemy, and then also, I like how you call it audio prescriptions.
Uh-huh.
You know, like, it's medicine. And it's, so I'm wondering, like, in your opinion, in music in general, and sound, and, like, what's the science behind it, in your opinion? Like, how does it affect us, like, and how is it beneficial for us for healing traumas and other things?
Well, I'm going to get my lab coat right here.
Yeah, lab coat on.
Well, apparently, the paradoxical effects of the stimulation of the cerebral cortex, the frontal cortex.
There is that, too,
there
right?
really is, and this, you're going to love
this,
right?
The pure science, and then the spiritual science.
Yes. And since I was 19, I remember at one point I used to go swing dancing, and there was a friend of mine who, I was playing some guitar, and he was just falling asleep, and he says, oh, your music is so relaxing. And I started talking to these people that are scientists, that go into neuroscientists, and go into the magic of sound, and then you hear all these different types of options that are out there with binaural beats, and...
With what?
Binaural beats.
Binaural beats?
Binaural beats.
I have no idea.
Yeah.
I've heard of binaural beats.
It's a really interesting phenomenon. And to be honest with you, there's other ones too, like isochronic tones. And then especially with the...
Have you heard of holosync?
Yes.
Are you familiar with them?
Those are binaural beats.
So wouldn't holosync be like a competitor for you? Or how would you...
No.
How would you rebut to someone who would come to you and say, well... Okay, so I'm looking at you, and I'm looking at holosync. Which one? Who should I go with, and why?
With that being said, there's something in relationship I was going to say too, because I'm glad that you're saying that timely.
Because holosync is also teamed up with scientists who have done
brain
research
training.
And all that stuff.
Exactly, and right. they've been doing it for years. And the thing is, I remember talking to someone, and he was telling me, without me like knocking anything, brain entrainment, wherever you are, it may resonate with you, and it may not resonate with you. In terms of doing
it's
that.
A different, yeah, everyone has a different, your take is different.
Your life, your rhythm.
Yeah.
So, with that being said, too, I've connected with different people. And I've attempted to connect with people in the 432Hz community. They go in and have these sound baths, and they tune, and they have certain goals. Again, they're doing amazing work. It's phenomenal. I've even attempted to reach out to people with the 528Hz, and people that would work with vibrational technology. And there's a gentleman who I just had on my show this week, who actually aired last week, who does spiritual technology, and he's more of a scientist versus a musician, and he goes through the mechanics of it, right? And I, for some reason, I would get pushback, even from neuroscientists, when I would ask about finding ways where I can sync up with them or find ways. And it was really interesting, and I'm thinking, for me, my integrity, I like putting the word grit and integrity.
Mm-hmm.
And just really when I say I'm going to show up. If I can't make it, I can't make it. So at the end of the day, here I am talking to this guy, this master, this guy that's worked with Michael Beckwith at Agape, guy who's, you know, I've worked with Stephen Halpern and all these like major people, and you know, has been featured in, you know, the news and documentaries. I mean, here's this gentleman in Pacific Palisades, Santa Monica area, and I would ask him, it's like the Wizard of Oz. So, I mean, how's the best way to go about it? You have these people talking about the chakras and all that jazz.
Right.
And he says,
it'd
honestly,
be pretty overwhelming.
At the end of the day, just follow your